Hello and welcome to this video on using Ansys Workbench Mechanical to place a load on the end of a pipe. There are a number of situations in which you may want to place a load on the end of a pipe. A model of a piping network may have given you forces that you're to put onto a solid 3D model of a pipe. That pipe might go into a vessel, a T-intersection, an elbow. Any number of situations could arise. You might have a model in which you used some one-dimensional piping elements and then want to connect them to a 3D model. You'd use the end of the one-dimensional pipe elements and use a remote point to attach the end of that 1D pipe to the face of a 3D model of a pipe, such as the red ring that you see in this image. Let's look at details of how this force was applied. It's been applied by using a remote point, this one right here. We've clicked on the front face of this pipe and clicked on location so that the remote point will be at the centroid of the cross-section of the pipe. We've gone down here and set the behavior to deformable. If we set it to rigid, we'd maintain a perfect circle, but then any thermal expansion would cause severe stresses on the perimeter here. It would also prevent radial expansion caused by internal pressures. So for reasons like that, we've chosen to go with a deformable end. However, forces and moments applied here could end up with warping of the end of this pipe. So we'll want the length of pipe out to where we applied the force to be reasonably large. I would say a minimum of 2.5 root RT, and possibly one or two diameters from any region of interest back here. It'll be up to the user to decide what would be a reasonable distance out to extend the pipe so that local disturbances don't affect the region of interest. Here's the remote force, and it's been directed to use a remote point rather than selecting geometry directly. Now the deformable behavior is inherited from the settings for the remote point. Here we have a force of 1,000 pounds in the minus y direction, so it's going to set this pipe up in shear. The other end of the pipe has been fixed, and this is the end where we're really interested in what the detailed three-dimensional stresses would be in a more complex model. Let's see what happens with these force application techniques. Now the end of the pipe distorts. That remote force is applied, but the end is deformable. It does allow thermal expansions, but it can result in some local, unrealistic deformations of the end of the pipe. You can see the deformations. They've been exaggerated to make them visible. Here's a total deformation plot, and you can see that the greatest amount of movement is right out here near the end. We can look at directional deformation if we want to. As a check on a model like this, a user should check the force reaction down here where we have the boundary condition, and you can see that it's 1,000 pounds up, so it's working properly. We can also check the moment reaction, which should be the force times the distance out that we are from where this simplified model was fixed. So that much is working okay, but we do see this severe deformation at the end. Let's look at some other ways of modeling this so that we lessen the disturbance here caused by concentrating a force on the end of a 3D solid model. Here's a variation on the model that we just observed. There's the same force and the same pipe on the right-hand side, and an extension piece has been built on the left. This is purely for modeling purposes. We have a multi-body part. So the two are joined together. There's no contact between them. The mesh is continuous. But they are separate bodies. Our remote point communicates with the face between these two bodies. If I go to a wireframe view, rotate the model, you can see that this face was selected for the remote point. For some reason, it's shown on the right side here, not the left side. Interestingly, if you put a remote force in, you can't get it to be applied to a face that's shared between two bodies in a multi-body part. but a remote point will do that and can be used for the remote force. So here you see the chosen remote point. Again, it's centered on the centroid of the area that you see. Let's go back to our solid view. Now the pipe on the left stabilizes the deformation of the pipe on the right-hand side. It's a slight improvement in what you just saw. You would have the same temperature on the left as on the right if you did this. You'd want to put an internal pressure on. The forces are applied on that shared face between them, though. So the piece on the left merely reduces the degree to which the pipe on the right is deformed by that remote force. Again, the remote force is applied with a deformable setting. This is shown manual, but the program controlled does the same thing. Let's look at the stresses now. The stresses right on the edge don't have quite the same severe effect. Let's look over the entire model. The approach isn't perfect. There's still a bit of a dimple in here. This is with an exaggerated deformation. Bit of a dimple because the remote force pulls on the single face in there. But the disturbance at the end of the part of interest isn't as severe. Of course, our region of interest still needs to be down here, away from where the force is put in. There's our directional deformation right out on the end. We can look at other things. The force reaction is still 1,000 pounds up, and we get that same moment reaction of 1968.5. So the model works. It's not perfect here, but the force on the end doesn't produce as much localized disturbance when the remote point's behavior is set to be deformable. Now we'll take a look at a third alternative. In a third alternative, we have our remote force in the same place. We're still working from a remote point, but the remote point now applies its effect on the entire outer face of the pipe extension. The remote point is still in the same position in space. It's right at the end of the piece of pipe of interest. The pipe on the left still has the purpose of stabilizing the piece on the right. The force now is not on the shared face. The force has its effect spread out this way, but it's still centered in the same position in space. The fixed support is as before. All other effects are the same. You would put the same, if it was a single temperature, you'd have the same temperature out here as you have in the piece of interest. Let's go see how the results come out in this approach. Here's our state of stresses in the part of interest. Now we no longer have a visible edge effect. Here's the stress in the entire model, and if I look at the right-hand side, you can't see much of a dimple where you go from the first piece of pipe into the second. There's our deformation. There's no visible dimple in the top. You can look at directional deformation on the end. There's almost no variation if you look at the legend here. Almost nothing in the X direction. We can go down and check our force reaction and see that it is still 1,000 pounds straight up. The moment reaction is still 1968.5. We can do other things. We can go in with some coordinate systems and put them at various places in the model. We can create construction geometry surfaces on those coordinate systems. We can check the moments on those surfaces and see that they vary in space the way we would expect them to in the piece of interest. You can check a force reaction where we make a cut and see that it's 1,000 pounds across the cut. What this means is that the variation of load in the piece of interest has the moment variation and the constant shear force that we would expect. It's just that by having the multi-body part in here with the body that extends and the one of interest, we do a better job of getting rid of a discontinuity. You can still see a slight effect, but we get rid of much of the effect of having a discontinuity between what's happening in the pipe of interest and the stabilizing piece out on the end. Once again, the remote force acts on the entire outer face of the pipe extension, but is still in the same position in space on the axis of the pipe at the end of the body of interest. So that's something for users to consider when they have to put a load on the end of a solid piece of pipe that goes into a complex structure, or perhaps if they have continuity between a line element for a beam and then a three-dimensional representation, using a remote point to talk to the face. They might put an extension on and spread the load over that in order to reduce the disturbance at the end when they use a deformable behavior so that they can have thermal expansions or radial expansion due to an internal pressure. Thank you for joining me.